Cantus Domus. So, just to explain for anybody who doesn't know or who isn't, who doesn't have all the information, not that I'm going to give all the information, but tonight is, today is, tonight is to mark the birthday of the Declaration, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which many, many countries have agreed to say, yes, we hold this up as a thing of principle and that we will do our best to uphold. And 69th birthday today, and next year is going to be the 70th. So between today, which is the beginning of a campaign that's going to be 1 year long, to bring the Declaration of Human Rights back into people's consciousness and back more into the world. And so it's a campaign that Amnesty are working on, and there are going to be a bunch of concerts during the year, finishing in a big, big concert here in Paris this day next year. And so we thought it fitting. We had a song that we had rehearsed together and played together before, and we thought it fitting to put some of the Universal Declaration, Article 1, in fact, is what we took, the first article, and put it into the song, because there's a part at the end of the song where the choir sang in Latin before, just different things, and this time we got the Declaration, and we had a few exchanges, and Ralph, who is conductor and choir master, if that's the title, he sent me a version of the Declaration, the Article 1, in Latin. And I read it in Latin. I don't speak Latin, but I just looked at it, and he says, does this look good? Do you like this? And I read it, and I was like, and I went, wow, okay, this was for some reason in Latin there was a lot of male energy coming off the page that I never saw before in English, because English is my normal speaking language and you get used to seeing things like you grew up, you know, speaking without really thinking about it. And when I saw it in a different language and I saw homines and fraternité and these kind of words coming at me off the page, I mean, fraternity, isn't that like a group of men in a college? And I just, you know, little symbolic and homines, and I was going after. So I wrote back and I said, is there any way that we can change the wording a little bit in Latin and so that it's not so male heavy in its language, but instead is actually, you know, 50% or more of the population on the planet are female, so surely the Declaration of Human Rights should represent those people as well. Just in the language, I know it does in theory, but even in the language, it should change. So we changed the words in English, and then we changed them into Latin. And so tonight we have a little taster of just this wonderful declaration, but just maybe a hint of a possibility of the idea that if this is something that we're going to bring back into society and really push for the next year, that maybe we can bring the conscientiousness of the fact that we really need to bring a balance between the male and female energy back into the world, and maybe we can get the language of this, this is my hope anyway, that we can get the language of this Declaration of Human Rights changed by its 70th birthday next year so that it represents everybody across the board, not just male and female, but male, female, and any variation of anything in between, so that it holds everybody. Anyway, thank you very much, I'm actually in a writing and recording period, so I'm sorry I forgot some words of the songs, and I didn't reach some of my notes because I'm not in singing mood, or not singing routine or whatever, but I hope that the spirit of the night and will forgive me for my hoarseness and forgetting my words, and I really do want to thank you all for coming here. It's, I really appreciate it. takes a lot to know a man. It takes a lot to understand. The warrior, the savior, the little boy in rage. It takes a lot to know. To understand what's humming, the honey bee, the sting, the little with wings. It takes a lot to live, to ask for help, to be yourself, to know. Love what you live with, a lot to breathe, to touch, to feel, the slow reveal of what another body.
It takes a lot to know a man, a lot to know, to understand.
To live, to ask for help, to be yourself, to know and love what you live with, a lot to breathe, to touch, to feel, the slow feel of what another body needs, a lot to live, to ask for help. You know you can't relax.